In this video, we explore the Oregon Dunes. We're staying at Osprey RV Resort in Lakeside, Oregon. So, hope you enjoy this video. Please like, subscribe, and leave a comment. Thanks for watching. This was our first day taking the side-by-side out to the dunes since we got here. We got here like 2 days ago and kind of settled in. We're here for 2 weeks, so we had plenty of time. So we were had figured out the route to take and what all we needed. And so this was our first experience out on the dunes. So we're going to stop first and see. There's a rental place up here on the left, and we wanted to see if you could get fuel there because we have a full tank right now, but obviously we're going to need fuel. But yeah, after we talked to him, we decided maybe that wasn't the best choice. I guess it depends on how desperate you are for fuel and if you have another tow vehicle, but $8 a gallon's a tad steep for regular gas. So we've got enough for today. We've got a full tank, so we'll just go get cans. It's just a few minutes down the road. But here's our first look at the dunes, and there's a little campground there. It's dry camping and for smaller campers. And then if we come on up and we find the sign to get out on the dunes, it does take us a little bit to figure out our way around here. Because it's dunes, and we haven't rode in dunes before, so finding the way around, and there's just trails everywhere, and sand everywhere, so, which makes sense when you think about it, but trying to find our way to get to the beach and the path and all, took a little doing, but we do get there, and it's a lot of fun to be out there. this is our first glimpse of the dunes, so we're kind of trying to, we saw the sign, and now we're trying to figure out where to go from there. It's trying to get oriented to the area, but how cool to be out there in all those sand dunes. Something we've looked at, and we had seen this many, many years ago when we had drove the coast, before we were RVing, long before we were RVing, and wanted to come back and play in the dunes, so finally a chance to go do that. A couple things to note, you do need to have a flag on your side-by-side. We did not change our tires. They do make sand tires. We didn't worry about that. But it's definitely different out here in the sand and how it maneuvers and all. But we did fine with our regular tires. I think Vic put it in four-wheel drive just to keep it, at least on part of the time, to keep when we were going up in the deep sand and up the dune. But it did fine. I mean, obviously, if you were really trying to kick up some speed, you'd better tires would help. But just dunes everywhere for miles. We know there's a beach around here somewhere. We're just trying to figure out how to get there. One other thing to note is it would be super easy to get turned around out here in the dunes because you see sand everywhere, and figuring out how to get around. It'd be easy to get turned around out here. So we were using Onyx, didn't show the trails because obviously the trails changed because the sand dunes moved, but it did show us, I could at least tell where we had came and which was, you know, the direction we wanted to go and where the beach was, and it did show some basic things. So it worked really well out there, so we could kind of figure out where we were and how to get back from where we wanted to be. So great time out there. I'm playing on the dunes. And the weather was great. It was cooler, probably 65, 70. And for us, that's a little cooler, but it was awesome to be out there. At this point, we could just feel that the beach had to be right around the next turn, or the next, you know. Okay, and clearly we were not nearly as close as we thought, so I'm going to speed this up to give you an idea of just how far off we were. I doubled the speed as we ripped through these trails and try to find the beach. We just wanted the beach. How hard could that be to find? But very cool riding out there. And clearly we weren't close, so I'm tripling the speed so I can show you just how far off we was. The dunes go for so many miles. But we do eventually find the beach. And here we are, finally, our first glimpse of the beach. It was about time. It took us a while to get there. It is absolutely stunning to get to the ocean, and the water was crisp and clear. Not too bad of waves. We do go another day when it's pretty wavy. Not a lot of people out here. We're here for the Labor Day weekend. Okay, that, it does get busy out here for Labor Day. I mean, really busy, but up until then, it just wasn't busy. We spent a lot of time just playing out in the water and exploring and riding down the beach, and just stunning out here. Not a lot of people here other than the holiday weekend. And there's a KOA you can stay at that didn't seem that busy. And Osprey Point, where we were, and then there's a lakeside campground that didn't seem busy other than the Labor Day weekend. And Labor Day weekend, it did definitely get busy, everything packed. Up until then, there was open sites to stay. And there's a lot of dry camping in this area. And a lot of people drag their, there's places you can drag your camper out on the dunes and stay. Not something we would do with ours, because ours is a lot of weight to get stuck and have to try to figure out how to get out, but there's a lot of people that camp out there, so pretty impressive. They're obviously braver than me. All the way down to as far as we could go in this direction, which is actually heading north down the beach, so we could find the barrier and then figure out how to get here for next time, because we spend a lot of time out on the dunes trying to find the path to get here. So we're going to do a little backtracking, figure that out, and then we'll explore further. Thank you. Right here is where we saw some of the people out here camping, but pretty impressive to get all the way back out here in the sand with their rigs. And what a cool campsite. There's lots of camping out here. Watch out here. Some of the people get running pretty hard. This one wasn't, but some of them get running pretty hard on these turns. And there's a lot of people out here, and they can get a little tight, so you do have to be aware. You do have to wear a helmet if you're under 18 or under, or under 18. And you have to,
yeah.
We wore them when we rode on the road. We were wearing them today. I think if you're over 18, you don't have to wear them when you're out on the dunes, just on the roadside. So that was our theory anyways, but helmets are always a good idea, so you choose your poison. But I know kids have to wear them, or at least kids are supposed to wear them. And you do have to, you are supposed to have flags on your side-by-side, and it's okay. Obvious why. It's hard to see, and with the dunes, it's really easy to miss seeing someone. I didn't see a lot of people using hand signals for people coming. So I don't know if that's a thing they do out here. We didn't see very many people using hand signals. So, you know, you just, like anything, use caution.
That way, but yeah.
I will say the views from up here are stunning, but driving up and down the dunes made me more than a little bit uptight. A, you couldn't see other people coming, and I'm not used to doing dunes. It was an experience. After we did it a few times, it wasn't nearly as scary. Like anything, you haven't done it, so you don't know. You know, the shifting sands, and people said be careful so you don't, you know, tip over. So all that, once we done it, rode over a little bit, I got a little bit better. But we take my mom out on another day with the puppies and let them see the dunes too. So had a great time.
Looks like you can just drive right over there.
I don't think you can. She's dragging her jacket.
And the kid behind her ain't letting her know. Don't get up on top of that one, she's hiding.
Okay. Can you hear my enthusiasm? And this is where Vic tries to scare me and does a pretty darn good job.
Don't stress me out that way.
We're getting old there.
Well, they just look straight up. Then you run out of go-go news.
Well,
I don't want to tank down. I thought I would get that far into it.
The light went out there too. That's me.
Okay, he might have stressed me just a tad, but the problem is the GoPro doesn't really show how much you're leaning. And he started going up, and he didn't put it in low range or four-wheel drive or whatever. And so it kind of started to bog. So then he just kind of turned into it, which is the right thing. But I just wasn't feeling.
Thank you.
right.
Well, that's the way out.
Yeah.
You can go this way. Oh, this way. Vic was not convinced I knew the way home, so he had to doubt me. So we decided to circle through the campground to take a look. This was a really fun day. We have a couple more days of riding, and I'll show you some where we run down the whole beach and see when Labor Day, when we have everybody out there. And but really great stop. Osprey Point RV Resort, I wouldn't call it resort exactly. There is a marina. There is a restaurant there. The food's good and reasonably priced. I wouldn't say it's exactly fancy. There is a marina. You can rent boats and stuff. It was really busy over the holiday weekend. It was not busy other than that. There are quite a few people that are there full time. It's nothing fancy, but it was fine for us. We didn't have any issues there. And it was convenient for us to get to the dunes. There are some other, in another video, I'll talk about when we do a drive, when we go on up the coast, we spotted some other RV parks that were nice too. So, we'll talk about that, but this one we stayed at because we could get to the dunes. Could get to the KOA from the KOA as well. I debated between the two, but I had read where they said, oh, if you want to go to restaurants, this is good. But honestly, we didn't go to the restaurant on the side-by-side. We could have taken the Jeep, and either one would have been fine. But it was a really great stay, and we had a great time. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you did, please like, subscribe, leave a comment, and remember, this might not be the right way or the wrong way to travel, but it is a way to travel. So, hope to see you down the road.
Thank you.